I don't know what other memories people have about Beecher Junior High, but mine started right here in the pool. This is where I learned how to swim, went on to high school, had a swimming scholarship, and went on to college. I spent my entire career with Hazel Park Schools, and right now I'm the informational director and technology coordinator. Tonight we're going to hear from a lot of people who attended this school or taught at this school. These people have different memories. We hope you enjoy our program tonight, which will show you all of the things that have happened over the last 74 years here at the old Hazel Park High School and now Beecher Junior High. So stay tuned. We think you're going to enjoy this. Michigan with a group of special ladies who all graduated from Hazel Park High School. And I'd like them to go around the table and introduce themselves and tell us what year they graduated. And we'll start over here with Darlene.
Hi, I'm Darlene Lundberg Savala, and I graduated in January 1960.
I'm Violet Roberts Fuller, and the year I would have graduated was 1953.
She's the old.
I'm Peggy Johnson Burry, and I graduated in June of 1958.
Let's go this way.
I'm Beverly Fox Roberts, and I graduated in January of 1959.
I'm Kathleen St. John Parker, and I graduated in June of 1960, the first June class from the new school.
I'm Marion Davidson McMinn. I graduated 1948.
Hello, my name is Shirley Hagenen Rice, and I graduated in 1962.
Hi, I'm Kathleen Hagenen Woodward, and I was the last class to graduate from the old high school, Hayes Park High School, in 1960.
I remember when the day Webb and Beecher split, I was in seventh grade, and day started off as it always did, and the seventh grade, we went to class, and partway through the day, the Webb students were called out of class, and they walked in mass away from the building, and that was the split of the buildings. That's when everybody went their own ways, and there was a crosstown rivalry, and everything changed.
Hi, my name is Trisha Cumberledge.
Hi, my name is Gary Scalrin.
Hi, my name is Tanya Lucas, and I just want to say that I'm going to be missing Beecher, when we go to the new school, and I'm looking forward to it because I want to see, be in the new building with web people, and I don't know, I'm just looking forward to having a great end of the year.
I really like the teachers at Beecher Junior, especially Mr. Guthrie, and I'll see him in high school.
My favorite teacher is Ms. Peters, and I'm looking forward to sports because I'm really athletic. I'm looking forward to having the best volleyball team and a good football team and baseball team.
All right, I started teaching at Beecher Junior High School in 1966. I graduated from college and was hired by Dr. Newberry. I taught here for 2 years. Webb Junior High School was built, and I was one of the teachers who walked their class over to Webb Junior High School. And I taught at Webb for 2 years, and then retired sort of and had 2 children and came back in 75. And when I came back to Beecher, and I taught here 3 more years before being transferred back to Webb. My fondest memory, though, is walking the students from Beecher over to Webb. We had the whole class, and we walked right into Webb and went into our new classes, and that was in the spring, I think of 68, and it was a fun trip, and I understand they're going to be doing it again real soon. Thank you.
As the oldest Beecher staff person currently at Beecher, I look with regret at the closing of the school. I have many fond memories, but we are excited to be going to the new building, and I know the kids are excited because they'll have larger lockers, bigger hallways, newer classrooms, but we've enjoyed this school too, haven't we, class?
Yes.
We've had fun.
Hello, my name is Clarence Harm. I used to teach in this building. I started in 1957 when I came out of the services into the high school at that present time. I enjoyed teaching here. I was a print shop teacher, and I also had a couple study halls. A lot of memories of this building when I was here. We had, for example, we shared a teacher's room with the custodians, and a very small room with a band room right next door. You couldn't get very much accomplished in your prep and con hour. And it was a joyful place to teach, though. Most of the teachers that were here at that time are no longer with the district. Like me, I'm retired now and have been since 1986. I hope that the new junior high will have as many memories for the teachers that will be there as what this building has for me.
Hi, I'm Carolyn Dittenber. I am a student of this building, plus a teacher here for 32 years. I was born here in Hazel Park. I've lived all my life in Hazel Park. My husband taught here also. This is a fond memory of a building that means a lot to this district. And a lot of people are sorry to see it go, but there's such a beautiful thing being built behind it that I think even a better memory will be here. But this is a big place, and this is going to be missed very much. Thank you.
You know, it's kind of obvious from the introductions that you guys probably had a lot of fun in school. You obviously have known each other quite a while, and here you are meeting in Troy. And Peggy, the spokeswoman here, is going to tell us a little bit about how you have remained together all these years since graduating from high school. Peggy, it's all yours.
First of all, most of us grew up together on the same street, next door to each other, and we've known each other ever since we've been born. Marion here and Kathleen and Shirley are cousins, and I lived in between them. Marion used to babysit me. In fact, now she has been babysitting my grandsons. Beverly and her sister Violet lived on the next street from us on Mapledale. Darlene lived over on Annabelle, and Kathy?
I lived in Ferndale.
In Ferndale. But basically, we've all known each other all our lives, and we decided, I don't know how long it's been now, 10, 12 years ago, well, maybe, whatever, that we would meet together once a month at, take turns at everybody's house and play cards. It started as a pinochle club, but then we would lose, we would gain. Finally, we just decided that we would just do whatever we like. We'd just games. Usually play games and laugh and
reminisce.
Yeah. Yeah. And laugh. And have a good time.
When some loud bragger tries to put me down and says his school is great, I tell him right away, what's the matter, buddy? Ain't you heard of my school? It's number one in the state. So be true to your school. I got for football track. I'm proud to wear them now.
It's been a long time since I've been in this office. It seems kind of familiar. But I have a lot of memories from this school building. Back in 1949, I started here as a student, spent the next 6 years when it was the Hazel Park High School. Now, the 6 years, though, was because it was the 8th grade through the 12th grade back in those days. I have a lot of good memories of the school days here. And then I had another situation here where I came in right after college, and I was teaching here. Came back to Hazel Park and started teaching at the Hazel Park High School. And my third session here was when I came back and was part of the administration, and have real good memories of that, working with a very good staff. So I have a lot of good memories, and when this building's torn down shortly, none of my memories will go away. I'll still have all those good memories. The building doesn't come into that as far as the good memories. And I'm really excited, though, that they're going to have a brand-new, state-of-the-art junior high school that the people of Hazel Park have provided for the students. This is a wonderful place to go to school, and I wish good luck to all the students in the future.
Hi, my name is Richard Robbins, and I'm a former member of the Hazel Park Historical Commission. In 1929, September the 30th, they laid this cornerstone for this magnificent building. Behind this cornerstone is a time capsule, which we are currently unable to get to, but at some later date we will be able to get to it and to show the people of Hazel Park what was placed behind this cornerstone. Howard Beecher laid this cornerstone, and he was responsible for a lot of things in Hazel Park that we take for granted today. He was a member of the Exchange Club, a founding member, and they were associated with, and I'll read this out, the first police station in Hazel Park, the first traffic light on 9 Mile, the first fire department, the first post office, and the library, the first bus shelter, tree planting, John Erickson Memorial Library, a civic symphony, and many other items.
I live.
Hey, girl, gather round. Pick up the water I'm putting down. Ooh, baby, I'm your handyman. I'm not the kind that uses a pencil or a rule. I'm handy with the love and I'm no fool. I fix broken hearts, I know I really can. If your broken hearts need repair, I'm the man to see. I whisper sweet things, you tell all your friends, they'll come running to me. Here is the main thing I want to say. I'm busy 24 hours a day. I fix broken parts, I know I really can. If your broken hearts need repair, I'm the man to see. I whisper sweet things, you tell all your friends, they'll come running to me. Here is the main thing I want to say. I'm busy 24 hours a day. I fix broken hearts, I know I really can.
Pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel, pretty little angel, pretty little, pretty little, pretty little angel.
Do you guys remember when we used to go to the tomb?
Yeah,
it was out like that. And I have to tell you what happened this one night. It was after high school, Hazel Park football game. Bunch of us went up. I keep thinking it was you guys, but it must have been back to her. You know who I'm thinking it must have been? Margie Donna and Sue Robinson. We go out there with two loads of girls and these guys overheard us in the beginning. So they went out there. There was three of them. They got there ahead of us, went up above the tomb. We were... Am I supposed to say?
Yeah.
We were drinking.
Hey, the man. First nickel in.
And we went up above the tomb, and we were just going around talking, and Carrie and I. The next thing we know, all of a sudden, these guys, they start rising.
Anybody?
No, they had sheets over them.
Kathy's
I mean, we were so scared. We were pulling each other.
Well, at this point, I know you all then share graduating from Hazel Park High School, and I'd like to, if I may, pass this around the table, and if you remember anything in particular about Hazel Park High School that you'd like to talk about, now's the time. And we'll start back here with Darlene.
Well, we just had our 42nd reunion. It was 43rd reunion, mm-hmm. And we sort of went through with some of these things and try to remember things that in the neighborhood in near the high school, we would go to the bakery, we would go to Rosina's for pizza, Mambo's, and then we'd go to the Hut, and we'd go to the Pot right across from the old Lacey High School. And generally, I really enjoyed high school. I think it was good, and it was a good, I really feel like the 1958 football team was so cool. We went to every single game that year, mm-hmm. all over. Flint.
And the buses.
Everywhere on the buses. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
That was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And then I remember when we beat Ferndale, I ran over to that radio station there on 9.5 and told them.
We won.
Well, I remember, this was about 1950, I remember Dr. Webb, only I don't believe he was Dr. Webb at that time, it's Mr. Webb, and he was my study hour teacher. And I remember that when he banged that desk, boy, we all just come to attention. And I also remember a favorite teacher, and this was 1952, and her name was Mrs. Titsworth, and she had a math class that made it so exciting for us, just the way she taught the math class. It just couldn't wait to get in her room and have math.
Darlene mentioned the 58 football team. That was the year I graduated, and we won the Southern Michigan League Championship. And if I'm not mistaken, that's the first time we beat both Royal Oak High Schools, too, that year.
We
beat everything, yeah. It was really good. But my one sort of funny memory is, I think it was 11th grade or 12th grade when you could sign up for business. I wanted to take bookkeeping. And, now that I got to tell the story, do you think I can remember the teacher's name?
Gray?
Yes, I think so. And so I had signed up for it, and then I got called down to Mrs. Schoening's office. And she says, "Peggy, you can't take bookkeeping." I said, "Huh? Why not?" She says, "Well, because you and Miss Gray won't get along." Was there another one that taught it?
Who was the lady that lived across the street from
Crawford? Vanna Pearl.
She was speech or English or
I have a lot of fond memories of the high school as well, going out to lunch to the Rosanna's, which the girls were talking about. And I used to enjoy having a lot of fun and being a jokester, and kind of I was elected, I think the year that I graduated, unofficially the class clown, because that year we couldn't have official class clown because they were trying for like an A rating on our yearbook that year. So, but I have a lot of fond memories of all my friends, and I enjoyed the high school very much.
I think what's cool about this group is not only were we close in school, but we hung around after school too. Many, many parties that I can't even tell you about. But we had lots of fun. Lots of fun, lots of guys, and lots of good memories. I think about the Hazel Park Five and Dime, too, that was up on John R.
Henry's,
that's what it was called.
The wooden floor.
Yep, it had the squeakiest wooden floors.
Big chunks of
chocolate. Carl Tom at Harmony House down the street from there. There's just a lot of good memories. And it's kind of unique that we're still all together and still have a lot of fun with each other.
Well, my fond memory of Hazel Park High School is that I met my husband in the 8th grade, and we're still married.
Wow.
That's neat.
How many years? To say, really. Let's see. I just remember one time when I was lost or something, and I went to open up the doors where the guys were swimming, and I opened the doors, and there they were all around the pool, all naked, and I got really, really nervous, and I slammed the door shut, and oh boy, well, that's all I know. Okay, bye.
My first record was Bobby Darin's from the Harmony House. When I was about 14, I got it for my birthday.
And what was it?
Bobby Darin,
Mac the Knife.
And pajama parties, all the pajama parties. And we're riding your bike all summer long.
Coming in when the street lights were
on. Oh, yeah. And used to have a club. She'd have to bring an apple and orange to get into the club, Darlene, there.
I came from two streets.
Peggy had the little wagon with the little things in it. It was the house trailer, house wagon with her dolls and little dishes.
Yeah, I remember.
We went down to the corner.
Yes, there were the woods. To the woods there. It was all woods. Then there was Perry awning and Candy, Mrs. Work, old neighbor Work there. We'd go save our pennies. We only saved about a nickel, and we'd have to go spend it on candy right away. And that's about it. And
What was the name of the jewelry store across
Gales.
That's where we all got our friendship.
Oh, and Lacey Junior High. And Soupy Sales was there at Lacey Junior High there on the stage. Never forget it. And that, what was her name, Bunny?
Yeah.
That tall lady Bunny was with them. Yeah, and how Tony Licata did the chicken.
Oh, Tony.
Played basketball in Lacey Junior High.
We had a lot of fun with Tony at the reunion.
Yes, the reunion was wonderful, seeing all the people. Not too many of ours came, though, but there's a lot of her class, Kathy's. Okay.
Well, I don't know about you out there, but I sure want to party with these ladies right now after all these fine memories. So, ladies, thank you for being with us. I know that your friendships will last forever, and thank you for reminiscing about Hazel Park High School.
Thank you.
Hello, I've been a teacher here at Beecher for 31 years. Besides teaching, I've coached and I've been athletic director. And one of my fondest memories here is one day I was doing balcony supervision during a basketball game, and an elderly gentleman, probably a grandfather of one of the students, started climbing up the bleachers in the gym balcony. Well, I said, "Sir, I can get you a seat on the first level here." He goes, "Oh, no, no, no." So he continued to climb up to the top and scooted over to the corner. And he was up there for about 10 or 15 minutes, and then he slowly came down the bleachers. And I again said, "Sir, I could have given you a nice seat right at center court here." He goes, "No, when I was a youngster here, when I was a student, I sat up there and I carved my name, and I just wanted to know if it was still there." I said, "Well, was it?" And he said, "Yes, it was." So I thought that was pretty neat. I hope tonight everyone finds that special place here at the building, where maybe you had a good time or a good moment with another student or a teacher. And we hope you have a real nice visit. Thanks for stopping by and sharing this celebration with us.
Well, I hate to leave you, baby. I don't mean maybe, because I love you so. Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go. Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go. I hate to leave you, I really must say. Oh, good night, sweetheart. Good night. Your mother, oh, and your father. Like it if I stay here too long. One kiss in the dark, and I'll be going. You know I hate to go. Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go. Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go.